Good morning. Welcome to the world of animal kingdom. Today, we can study the characteristic features of phylum Platyhelminthes.
Phylum Platyhelminthes. Phylum Platyhelminthes actually called as flatworms. They are dorsoventrally flattened. Dorsoventrally flattened organism. You can see that tapeworm, planaria, liver fluke, these all are example for Platyhelminthes, phylum Platyhelminthes. So dorsally or dorsoventrally flattened organism. You see, so that they are flatworms. We can see other features very important. Okay, as I told you that Platyhelminthes means flat worms. Platys means flat, helminthes means worm. So their body dorsoventrally flattened. What are the salient features of these Platyhelminthes? They are dorsoventrally flattened like a leaf. They show organ level of organization. You know that tenophora, that is tissue level, Platyhelminthes, organ levels of organization. They are acoelomate animal. Acoelomate means absence of coelom. What is coelom? Coelom is the cavity between body wall and gut wall. That we can call as coelom. So Platyhelminthes are acoelomate animal. Coeloms are absent, keep in mind. Then they are triploblastic animal. Triploblastic. What's the meaning of triploblastic, you know? Diploblastic means they have ectoderm, endoderm. By their embryonic or germinal layer or embryonic growth, ectoderm, endoderm. From these two germinal layers they undergoes growth. Or from germinal layer, these two germinal layers they have. Embryonic layer, okay. Ectoderm and the diploblast. This triploblasty. What's the meaning of triploblastic? They have ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. Three germinal layers will be there from the embryonic stage. The organism which formed from these three germinal layers we can call as triploblastic. Okay. So that's why they are triploblastic. Keep in mind that Platyhelminthes onwards organism are triploblastic. Very important point. Platyhelminthes onwards Ascalimindus, Annelida, Arthropodes, all are triploblastic. Okay. Then they are bilaterally symmetrical. Bilaterally symmetrical. What is bilateral symmetry? What is the meaning of bilateral symmetry? That means if we cut an organism through a central axis, we will get equal halves. Okay, a plane through central axis. A central axis, we will get two equal halves. That is called as bilateral symmetry. Is it? So they are bilaterally symmetrical. Then some members of have segmented body. Segmented body. What is segmented body? Some members. Actually, segmented body shows that annelids, mostly firstly we can say metamerism, you know, metamerism. That means body internally and externally divided into many segments. That is called as segmentation or metamerism. Okay, firstly we can say that that is phylum Annelida has segmented body. In these members, some only have segmented body. Then what is other feature? Many of them have parenchyma cells give rise to muscle cell. That's why you know that ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. Mesoderm actually between ectoderm and endoderm, mesoderm. So parenchyma cells are there. So muscle fibers are forming from there. That also. Keep in mind then. Then digestive system is incomplete with a single opening, mouth and anus is absent. You know that complete digestive system and incomplete digestive system. Complete digestive system means they have two openings, mouth and anus. That is complete. Incomplete digestive system is only one opening for ingestion and ingestion. So, Plathy Helminthus, keep in mind that digestive system is incomplete with a single opening, mouth and anus is absent. Anus is absent. Okay. Then what is other feature? Mostly endoparasite found in animals including human being. Endoparasite and ectoparasite. What's the difference between endoparasite and ectoparasite? Endoparasite means the organism, they live inside other host, inside, and taking food or nutrients. That is called as endoparasite. Ectoparasite means, ecto means outer. They live outer part of organism or host. Okay. That is called as ectoparasite. Endo means inner. Ecto means outer. Clear? So, they are mostly endoparasitic found in animals including humans. Okay. What is the other feature? The respiratory organs are absent. They have no respiratory organ. Okay. Respiratory organs are absent. In parasite, respiration is anaerobic. Okay. Respiration anaerobic. And there is no circulatory system. Circulatory system is absent. Then what's the important feature? Very important feature. The excretory system is formed of protonephridia. Very important. Protonephridia or flame cell. Protonephridia or flame cell, which help in osmoregulation and excretion. You know that. In our cases, kidney. Two kidneys are there. What is the function? What are the function you know? Only excretion only? No, it has the role of osmoregulation also. So mostly excretory system function is that excretory system which help for excretion and also osmoregulation. Like that, excretory system in these Plathy Helminthus, what is protonephridia or flame cell help in osmoregulation and excretion. Okay, keep in mind that.